Good evening, friends. I am Dr Ajay Kantharia, consultant physician at Colaba, Mumbai. And today we are going to discuss a few important points on hypertension. Hypertension, also known as blood pressure, it is said it is one of the silent killer. Why silent killer? Because hypertension as such does not give any pain. As I always tell everybody, if you have a dental pain, you are not going to wait. You are going to rush to a dentist immediately. Whereas blood pressure, hypertension, it does not give us any pain. It gives us pain only when it is too late. There are various studies and various medical bodies which tells us that we have to keep our blood pressure under control. Only problem is that the blood pressure never remains constant. It always fluctuates. Day to day, minute to minute, there is called daytime variability, or morning blood pressure might be different from evening blood pressure. But in a normal individual who does not have a blood pressure problem, who does not have a hypertension, his blood pressure should remain within a constant range. When it goes above a range of, let us say, 140 by 90, the patient is said to be hypertensive and needs to start medication. Let us look at a typical patient who comes to our clinic. A young gentleman, let us say 35 years old, comes to the clinic and is on a routine examination. His blood pressure is found to be 140 by 90. He will give you various excuses, or rather he will give me, a doctor, various excuses of why his blood pressure is high today. Maybe he has come running, maybe he's under stress, or whatever it is. Okay, so in such a situation, it may not be important or it may not be urgent to control his blood pressure or to rush for a medication. For blood pressure and diabetes, we say the first important treatment is lifestyle modification. What does it mean? It means that we need to modify the lifestyle, cut down the and modify the diet, cut down the salt intake and all the salty stuff which goes along with our diet. For example, patient will say, I don't eat salty food. My wife, spouse, cook, prepares food without salt or less salt. But we forget that sometimes the salty items could be include papad, wafer, chivda, pickles. The most favorite of the children is the various chips. This contains a lot of salt. Hypertension and diabetes, I always say these are two friends. If a person has hypertension, the diabetes will be invited. If a person has diabetes, hypertension will be invited. And we need to tackle both these things with lifestyle modification. Regular checkup of blood pressure is extremely important, whether you check with your family doctor, whether you check at home, but it is important to keep a track of your blood pressure from a very young age. One factor we have to remember as far as the blood pressure and home blood pressure checking is concerned, that sometimes patient can become very hyper about examining their blood pressure, checking their blood pressure regularly. Now, that should not happen. It should not happen that they get obsessed in checking their blood pressure at home. That itself creates a tension, that itself perpetuates blood pressure. What about medication? Fortunately, we have various group of medication as far as blood pressure is concerned. The most popular one, most effective one, it's called angiotensin receptor blocker, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitor, calcium channel blockers. This gives a very nice and a smooth control of blood pressure to a patient. But it is important to remember to adjust the dose of medication on a regular basis. Now, sometimes the patient tend to forget taking the medication. Sometimes they over-medicate themselves. The first thing that they want to know is when to stop the medication. It is important to stress that most of the time, blood pressure medication are for lifelong. Unless for some reason the patient has developed hypertension because of some particular illness or medication, then this patient blood pressure will taper off with tapering of that particular medicine. The other variety of blood pressure or hypertension is called secondary hypertension. What does secondary hypertension means? It means that there is some particular reason for the blood pressure to develop. For example, let us say a person has called an entity what is called pheochromocytoma, or let us say he has got adrenal adenoma, or let us say he has renal artery stenosis. Now these are what is called correctable factors as far as the blood pressure is concerned. You take care of these factors, you treat this primary predisposing factor, and then the blood pressure is taken care of without medication. So let us say a person develops hypertension because of pheochromocytoma. We have to undertake a surgery for pheochromocytoma, and then the blood pressure will settle down. So it is important to rule out secondary hypertension in somebody who is very young, or if in an elderly person we find out some predisposing factors. Hypertension is also a great risk factor for coronary artery disease and especially stroke. Whenever we have patient of stroke or a coronary artery disease, we have to look at their blood pressure very carefully. So we have to be careful of making sure that the blood pressure is under good control, within the range, with minimum number of medicine and a good lifestyle modification. Thank you.